Good morning,
and welcome to our Eucharistic celebration, honoring the life of Sister Ramona Medina and the gift she has been to us and among us. We offer our deepest sympathy to Ramona's family, both here in the chapel and joining us by live stream. For congregational members, we offer sympathy too, and all of her friends and caregivers. Our vigil service last night centered around the Magnificat, Mary's song of praise, honoring God's great gift of love in Mary's life. We commemorated Ramona's awareness of the great gift of love, of the love of God that had been given to her and which she constantly poured out to others. In our celebration today, we use the music and scripture readings to point up significant things which we have noted about Ramona's life. In the first reading, we speak of God being the spring of life-giving water and making all things new. Ramona's life was a faithful outpouring of life-giving waters, renewing people's spirits wherever she went. The second reading reminds us of what Ramona so deeply believed and lived, that nothing can separate us from the love of God. In the Gospel reading, we are reminded that Ramona has an eternal dwelling place prepared for her by Jesus, who is and always has been in her life the way, the truth, and the life. Ramona, though we mourn your passing, we celebrate the wonder of you and your many gifts with great love, knowing that you have truly been made new in the love of God.
Let's sing together. I'm the bread of life, verses 1, 4, and 5, number 3, 1.
We now place on the urn, in front of the urn, the profession cross and the constitution of the Sisters of St. Joseph. They are a sign of consecration and the unity of selfless love manifested with one another and the dear neighbor. May Christ now greet Sister Ramona with these words of eternal life. Come, blessed of my God. And let us pray. Listen kindly to our prayers, O Lord, as our faith in your Son, raised from the dead, is deepened. And may our hope of resurrection for your departed servant Ramona also find new strength. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
Please be seated for a moment. Thank you. faith also in me. In my Father's house there are many dwelling places. If there were not, would I have told you that I'm going to prepare a place for you? And if I go and prepare a place for you, I will come back again and take you to myself, so that where I am, you also may be. Where I am going, you know the way. Thomas said to Jesus, Master, we do not know where you're going. How can we know the way? Jesus said to him, I am the way and the truth and the life. No one comes to the Father except through me. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
The Gospel passage chosen for Ramona's funeral today, Jesus shares a metaphor or image that's very powerful and tender and reassuring for us. It's a promise he makes to his disciples before his own death, preparing them for his own passion and death. Recall his words, do not let your hearts be troubled. Trust in God, trust in me. There are many rooms in my Father's house. If there were not, would I have told you that I'm going to prepare a place for you? Jesus goes to prepare a place for you, for me, for Ramona. There's room for us. This passage addresses some of our deepest fears. The fear of being forgotten. The fear of being left out or left behind. And it also appeals to our deepest needs. Our need to be loved, our need to be cared for, and not be forgotten. The promise appeals to our need for unity and communion, the need to know that we are safe and that we will be saved from all that threatens us. This passage is especially meaningful as we celebrate Ramona's life and continue to pray for her and with her. I suggest that this gospel passage captures much of Ramona's spirituality in a way, how she lived her Christian faith with us. This was the gospel passage I shared with Ramona numerous times whenever we had Holy Anointing, the sacrament of the sick, with her as her health continued to decline. So she was very familiar with this gospel passage. She understood the words of Jesus because much of her time and energies were spent in preparing a place for others. Preparing a place for others in her heart, in her life, in her priorities, in her ministry, in her daily life as a sister and aunt and member of a religious community and family member, co-worker, friend, and neighbor. And there's many examples of how Ramona was always preparing a place for others. Last evening, the vigil service, Sister Judy mentioned many examples of the way Ramona prepared a place in her heart to love those around her. I'm not going to go into that much detail, but just to highlight some examples. Ramona prepared a place in her heart for her siblings. There was a lot of love that they shared. Such a large family. 13 children in her immediate family. Ramona and her life story, her autobiographical reflection, speaks about the beauty of love she experienced in her family growing up. They may have been materially poor, but they were not poor in what really matters, and that's love. And this love carried over to adult life, as Ramona had a place in her heart always for her family, extended family, her nieces and nephews. She made family gatherings a priority, sometimes traveled great distances to be with you because she had that place in her heart for you. As a young woman, Ramona prepared a place in her heart for God's call to the vow of religious life. She is attentive and receptive at a very young age how God was inviting and encouraging her and calling her to serve as a religious sister. And as we know, she's first drawn to become a religious sister in the Benedictine community in Ashington, and then responded to the call to join the Sisters of St. Joseph in 1980. She wrote in her life story about the day she joined the Sisters of St. Joseph. She wrote, "On that memorable day, I felt a profound peace. And I knew this is where God wanted me to serve God and dear neighbor." So Ramona's heart was always had a place for God's voice, God's call, God's invitation. Ramona prepared a place in her heart for service, the building of God's kingdom in various ways. This first found expression in her teaching career, her vocation of teaching. And later her passion to give her life in service to God's kingdom in a vocation as a registered occupational therapist. And as a member of Sister St. Joseph, she developed occupational therapy departments in various hospitals and homes. Sister Judy highlighted last night. Just as a side note, I looked up the official definition of a registered occupational therapist. It's quite dry. It's quite scientific. This is one definition, and it's a mouthful. To assess, plan, organize, and participate in rehabilitative programs that help build and restore vocational, homemaking, and daily living skills, as well as general independence to persons with disabilities or developmental delays. It's all one sentence. It's a mouthful. All very technical. But Ramona gave it a face. She steeped in her own Christian formation, Christian spirituality, and love for neighbor. She deepened and extended the meaning of what it meant to be an occupational therapist. By assisting patients to regain certain life skills, yes, but Ramona's mission was to share God's love and help provide them with hope, courage, and determination. Ramona's mission was to help them rediscover the beauty of their lives in the midst of disabilities and other health struggles. To put it another way, as a medical professional, Ramona did not ask her patients, "What's the matter with you?" But rather she asked, "What matters to you?" What matters to you? What mattered to her patients was a starting point of her ministry. She was person-centered. Didn't simply focus on the prognosis or illness or disability. Her focus was being united with the neighbor. And the various awards and public recognition that Sister Judy highlighted last night is a testimony to the passionate love with which she shared herself. Just a final example, preparing a place in her heart for neighbor found a special expression in 2002 when Ramona, along with Sister Jean Befford and Pat McMahon, founded Neighbor to Neighbor, a day center for women and children in Concordia. That's when I first met Ramona. Almost 20 years ago, I was passionate parish here. She was a dynamo, a little firecracker. When I first met her, full of passion, full of energy, full of inspiration. And Ramona was a creative organizer and inventor of ideas, and also taught painting and art to the women and children who came to Neighbor to Neighbor. And through art, Ramona helped her clients not only to create beauty on the canvas and other materials, but also she helped them to discover their inner beauty, the beauty of their lives in the eyes of God. Ramona had the capacity and disposition to truly engage the women she was helping. Many of you are here today. She recruited them with various projects sometimes, art projects, that were then used here at the Motherhouse. This also helped them create beauty for others and know their own beauty. So Sister Ramona wrote in her life story that she aspired to, in her own words, she aspired to create beauty and help others to create beauty. To create beauty and to help others to create beauty. I suggest that this mission to create beauty in life and help other people create beauty was a theme carried out throughout her life in various roles and positions and vocations. She was able to create such beauty because she had a roomy heart. selfless love we manifest with one another and with our neighbor. The sign of consecration is the unity of selfless love we manifest with one another and with our neighbor. Ramona radiated that unity of selfless love in her various spiritual and corporal works of mercy, both within the congregation as well as in the broader community around us. It was Christ living in Ramona that allowed her to show these virtues that we remember and fondly cherish. The love she shared was just not her own love. It was Christ's love living in her. And sacred scripture reminds us God is love. Those who abide in love abide in God, and God abides in them. Sometimes you and I are not always consciously aware of how God is loving us through our neighbor. Christ's presence among us is experienced in the world through such virtues as generosity, faithfulness, fortitude, courage, hope, self-sacrificial love. This means every encounter with neighbor carries the potential of an encounter with Christ. So we shed tears this day not only because of grief, which is natural and healthy, but also because of thankfulness. We give praise and thanks to God that through Ramona's life, we were able to experience something of God's love that surrounds us each day. A love that's inviting and inclusive. A love that creates beauty in our lives. be taken up into glory with your Son, in whose great mystery of love we are all united, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with
your spirit. Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
And let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere, to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty, Eternal God, through Christ. In Him, the hope of blessed resurrection has dawned, that those saddened by the certainty of dying might be consoled by the promise of immortality to come. Indeed, for your faithful Lord, life is changed, not ended, and when this earthly dwelling turns to dust, an eternal dwelling is made ready for them in heaven. And so with the angels, the archangels, the thrones and dominions, with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory, as without end we acclaim. The mystery of faith. Reconcile us to yourself. Grant that we who are nourished by with your elect, especially with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with your blessed apostles and glorious martyrs, and with all the saints, on whose constant intercession in your presence, we rely for unfailing help. And may this sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. We please confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth with your servant Francis, our Pope, and Gerald, our Bishop, order bishops, all their clergy, and the entire people you have gained for your own. And remember your servant Ramona, whom you have called from this world to yourself. Grant that she, who was united with your son in a death like his, may also be one with him in his resurrection, when from the earth he will raise up in the flesh those who die, and transform our lowly body after the pattern of his own glorious body. And to our departed brothers and sisters too, and to all who are pleasing to you at their passing from this life, give kind admittance to your kingdom. There we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory, when you'll wipe every tear from our eyes, for seeing you, our God, as you are, we shall become like you for all the ages, and praise you without end. Through Christ our Lord, through whom you bestow on the world all that is good. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever. away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord,
those who cannot come forward for communion will be bringing it to you after everyone else has received. If you don't want to receive communion, you can receive a blessing. Simply place your hand across your chest. Thank you. Grant, we pray, O Lord, that your servant Ramona, for whom we have celebrated this paschal sacrament, may pass over to a dwelling place of light and peace. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
After our concluding prayers together, you're invited, if you so wish, after you so wish, we'll be processing out to the cemetery for the burial. Just follow the leader. Trusting God, we pray together for Ramona. Now we come to the last farewell. There is sadness and parting, but we take comfort in hope that one day we'll see Ramona again and enjoy her friendship. And although this congregation will disperse in sorrow, we believe the mercy of God will gather us up together again in the joy of his kingdom. Therefore, let us console one another in the faith that we share in Jesus Christ. Let us pause and offer in silence our own personal prayers for Ramona and for her family.
Let us sing our song of farewell to Ramona, number 8.
Please use your sheets and dry them in the pews for Santa Maria de la Vida.